Yo!
What up? Jason Trio here with Bitrio.com. Today is Thursday, January 16th, 2020. Another day, another video, another tweet. All right, Splinterlands. And dude, my throat is killing me, dude. All this yelling, shit. I think it's catching up with me. I got coffee here, black coffee. And doing black coffee. Today is day two of my black coffee. Not that I'm on a counting thing with coffee. Not really counting, but being sick, not feeling the best. You know, sick, right? What is sick? I don't really know. Kind of sick, but still not stopping me from doing my shit. I'm just cutting the creamer out. Cutting the creamer out. And I don't know what it is, you know, maybe it's this whole sober 2020 thing, being sober, and my body's like reacting somehow, saying, yo, where's the drugs, bro? You know what I'm saying? Maybe that's going on. Maybe my body's like, yo, we getting fucked up or what? The fuck's going on? I'm trying to get ripped tonight. And I'm just not having it. So, you know, maybe I'm getting fucked up like that. Mucus is coming out. Shit's happening. But it's good. Good shit is happening. We're here. And if you can't go 1 year sober, then what the fuck are you doing? You're a fucking bitch. And that's my mentality, dude. I got to. I have to. As a man. I have to be able to go 1 year sober, man. I mean, come on. Come on, dude. If I can't do that, I'm a fucking bitch. And I gotta do it. And I'm doing it. Here it is. 2020 is the year. And 2021, I'm gonna be fucked up! Probably not. I won't be fucked up, but I'm probably gonna get... I'm gonna have some beers or something. That's for damn sure. A few days of beers. Maybe some blazing out. You know, we'll see what happens. We'll see what 2021 brings. But for now, we're sober, we're doing our dailies. Also, my chest is hurting too. My left pec was hurting, like my lower pec. Been doing my 100 push-ups a day, and I was doing some decline presses, push-ups, whatever, with my feet elevated a little bit, and now my left pec, my left titty! It's a little sore. I was feeling it like, ouch. So I don't know, man. I can't rest. There's no rest when you're doing 100 push-ups, 100 bodyweight squats, and 100 sit-ups every single day. No excuses. The body must adjust. My body's got to get used to it or else. You got an Untamed Edition booster. All right. Let's crack this booster. See what we get. Come on, Splinterlands gods. Give me something good. No. Nothing good. Again. Death Splinter quest. Man, we can't even get on a quest either. Shit. Oh, so yeah. So I'm doing the whole black coffee thing. And I was thinking about doing a fast. You know, I'm in my mid-30s, man. I haven't fasted not once in my life. And I think I gotta do that. I think I gotta fast, man. I mean, fasting is amazing. Heals you and shit. So I gotta fast, and I was thinking maybe this weekend, because you got the holiday, MLK Day coming up. So, you know, maybe do a fast. It's just so hard, dude. I love to eat, man. I love the foods. I love the foods. That is just so freaking hard. But I know, man, you know, it's called self-control. Do I have it? I don't know. But I'm trying to have it, man. Self-control is the ability to make yourself do what you should do, whether you want to or not. Now, I guess you need some judgment to be like, huh, what should I do? Well, I thought I should do that. I didn't know it was dumb. You know, you have to have some sort of smarts about you to be able to determine what's good and what's not good. And that quote, the definition of self-control came from some dude. I forget his name. Some old head. He's got white hair. He's a white dude. And I don't know. He was on the internet somewhere, and I was like, yeah, that's it. That's what I need, self-control. This was probably like 3 years ago, maybe 4 years ago, and I was starting to turn my life around. And I printed it out. I typed it up. So he made a video. He had a video or something talking about shit. I was like, yo, what did he just say? Rewind that. I typed it up in Word or something, notepad. And I was like, yeah, yeah, say it, say it. Typed it up. And then I printed it out and put it in my fucking cubicle. In my fucking cube. Hung that shit on the wall. I was like, yeah, that's what I need, self-control. And I've been slowly working on it ever since. You know, hey, I'm trying, man. I'm fucking trying. You know what I'm saying? That's all you could do. Not really. Stop being a bitch. No excuses. All you could do. No. You can do more. Don't be scared, man. You could do fucking more. That whole thing about, oh, I'm trying my hardest. No, you're not. Shut up. I don't want to hear that. I don't want to hear that you're trying your hardest. Just do it. Continue on. And if you're trying your hardest and you fail, you know, so what? It's not about even getting to a point. It's just about a continuation. That's what I'm learning as well, too. You know, it's not like when I become successful, you know, quote unquote, whatever the fuck that means. When that happens, I'm not just going to be like, okay, I'm done. You know, life's done. I'm good, bro. I made it. That's not what's going to happen. I got to still continue on my life. So let's say when I reach one of my goals, which is 1.5 million. 1.5 million. When I reach that, I can't just be like, all right, well, it's time to fucking party and just do all dumb decisions, you know, get fucked up, eat, get fat, and be retarded, you know. No, no. So life goes on, man. You have to continue on. That's something that I'm trying to learn, trying to grasp. I already kind of understand it, but if I'm being honest with myself, that's not what I'm going to do. If I had loads of money right now, I'd be a fucking fuck up. I'd be fucked up right now. Maybe that's why I don't have the money, because I'm not mature enough. You know what I'm saying? I'm not prepared enough. I haven't put myself in that position to deserve it or to get it. And for that, I guess I am thankful, because a lot of people get money. You know, their parents are rich and shit. They get handouts from their parents or however the fuck, and they fuck up. You know, they're put into this position where they have all this fucking privilege, you know, and I don't want to go down that white privilege. You know, fuck that shit. No, money privilege. Money privilege, motherfucker. You know, they got all that fucking, they just don't have to do shit. You know what I'm saying? They got money. They're rich, man. You know, they don't have to go to work. They don't have no responsibility. So that's probably the better word, responsibility. They don't have responsibility. So they can just fuck off all day. And then what happens? What do they normally do? They get hooked on heroin or some shit. That's usually what the fuck happens. Like, look at fucking Andy Reid's kids, dude. He's a fucking football coach out here in Philly. And his kids got hooked on heroin and fucking died, dude. Ain't that crazy? You know, the dad was rich, had mad dough. But unfortunately, the dad wasn't around, you know? He was coaching football, NFL, in the office early as hell in the morning, wouldn't leave till late at night, putting in mad hours at work and neglecting his family and his kids, you know? Now, I don't know him personally, but I can just imagine that's the lifestyle. And I'm probably not far off. And that sucks, you know? The kids were just like, yo, we got all this dough. We don't have daddy at home telling us what the fuck to do. You know, didn't have the man in the house saying, yo, beat that ass, boy. So they were just out there doing whatever the fuck they wanted, and they OD'd on heroin. Damn, that's fucked up. Yo. So, you know, man, I mean, I don't want that, dude. I got kids, man. I don't want that for my kids. You know what I'm saying? I do not want that for my kids. I want my shit to be good. My shit's gotta be good, man. No neutral. So what's that mean? I gotta roll two twos. Well, I can't do that. So this sucks. A three and a two. That's five. Okay, that sucks. Well, I guess we just go a four here. All right, we'll go. We'll run it. So that's life, dude. You know, you got to get your responsibilities in order, your priorities in order. You got to run your shit good before you can have the success. Because if you can't, you know, how can you expect yourself to be able to run your life and be good at shit in life when you're rich, when you can't even do it when you're poor? You know, and the answer is you're not, dude. You're not. You're not going to be able to do that shit. You're going to be a fuck up. You are a fuck up. And that's what I'm trying to avoid. Do not be a fuck up, man. So that's why I question too, playing video games. Like, what am I doing? I'm sitting right here playing video games. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. I one thing, you know, when I'm having a therapy session. That's one thing. Therapy is in session. Hello, Jason. Sit down in front of this mirror and express your thoughts to the internet. Well then, hello. You know, and that's it. That's just the start, man. That's just the start. This motherfucker's crazy, yo. That's just the start, dude. You know, you have to do something. I don't know what to do, so I'm gonna do something, you know? Let's go, put it in my face. 1.5 million, here we go. We have a goal, let's try to get it. How are you gonna get it? I don't know. You can make videos, man. You can make a little bit of money off of this. Look, you know, you get some upvotes on Steam. You get some tips through Bitcoin. What, somebody already sent me a tip, dude. I got my shit in the description. Somebody sent me, and thank you for that. It was months ago, too. It was like in the summer. And I already said thank you for that. So I don't know who it was, but somebody just sent me, I don't know, it was like 15 bucks. 50 bucks? I don't know what it was. It was 0.0055 Bitcoin. So that's what's up. And Library, you know, people sent tips on Library. Splinterlands upvotes on Steam. You know, so you could make money. You know, you could earn money. Now, is it a lot of money? No, it's not a lot of money. But getting off zero is a big thing. It's hard to get off zero, so you should probably do that. Show yourself that you can get off zero and then work and build and grow from there. That is the strategy. 10? Holy fuck. I guess I gotta go this and ditch somebody else. The wizard? 6? 7, 8. Yeah, I guess I gotta ditch the Wiz and go with a 5. Ditch the Wiz. I don't want to ditch the Wiz though, because he's got snipe, and I'm sure we're gonna see the Lord with the reflex. So I'd rather hit their second in line. But what are you gonna do? Wiz is still. Still good. I put Mermaid in instead. Mermaid needs a buff. Plus one health. Where'd that health go? Where'd that health go? Mermaid needs plus one health, man.
Come on and do it.
Alright, what are we facing here? Somewhat of the mirror, except he's got
this dude.
And he's got a level 10. Malnamur. So who do we have? We have the genie. In place. Are we gonna win? No, his team's better. Let's be honest. Let's be fucking honest. Could we win? Possibly. Will we win? Unlikely. Just because, what is he getting? He's getting an extra speed and a health. And what am I getting? An extra health? Yeah. Doesn't really work out here. All right, I lost my tank, but hey, he lost an attacker. So maybe he lost an attacker, dude. Now the stun is huge. He didn't hit with the stun. He lost two attackers. All right, we're down. We're down somebody, but he just lost Deuce.
The Deuce.
He just lost the Deuce, man. We don't have a CC. Oh, shit. Are we coming for this dude's life? Maybe. I don't know, man. It's gonna be fucking close, dude. Holy shit. Oh, that was it. That was it. If we would have killed right there, we would have won. It's the speed. The speed's going to do it. The speed is going to win it for him. But I'll tell you what. That was a lot closer than I thought it would be. That was a lot closer.
Oh, yeah.
So just making videos, you know, just trying stuff, doing stuff. Psychology, therapy sessions, talking to myself, talking to the internet. Being vulnerable, putting myself out there, being accountable. Also, hey, I'm going to make a video every day. Boom, I have to do it, even if I don't feel like it. Hey, I'm going to fucking do 100 push-ups a day. Boom, do it. Even if I don't fucking feel like it, I'm going to do that shit. I just cleaned out the fucking ice bath yesterday with the kids. It's going to be cold on Friday. It's going to be like 30 degrees or some shit, which is like 0 degrees Celsius, 30 degrees Fahrenheit. Let me check the weather real quick, too. Yeah, 35 it says, but that's still cold enough. The nights will probably be colder. Okay, yeah, so tonight it's going down to 27. 35 tomorrow and then 24. So Friday's going to be good. It's going to be icy, dude. So that water, it's probably already coming out of the hose. You know, what is it? It's probably like 60 degrees. You know, I'm getting a feel for this. So kind of knowing what the temperature is just by feel, just by touch. But I do have this fucking laser Joni over here. What is this? The infrared thermometer. Laser targeting. It'll target up to -4 Fahrenheit, which is -20 Celsius. So, you know, the water ain't getting that fucking cold. But it does get cold, man. It gets to fucking 32, 27. I think the coldest water I've been in was 27. So 27 degree water, it's fucking cold, man. I mean, that's negative degree water, I think. I think 32 is zero in Celsius, so. It's pretty good. It's pretty fun. You know, scary as fuck, let's be honest. Scary as fuck. But it's the real deal, man. It is the real deal. You gotta do it, you know? This is stuff you gotta do. You know, I don't wanna do that. I don't wanna get in that ice water, but it's such a good challenge. It's such a good mental hurdle that you could do to overcome. You know, you think you're badass. You think you're gonna be wealthy. You think you're gonna be successful. Then you gotta do things that's gonna prove it. You can't just sit around in your mind and be like, yeah, I'm awesome, dude. I'm about to do all this good shit. And then you never put pen to paper or foot to ground or action to reality and get shit done. You have to do it. And when you're not knowing what the fuck to do, because that's a huge problem with today, everyone in society, nobody knows what the fuck to do. I don't know what to do. It's a huge problem with me. I have to do something. You gotta do something. And this is that something, man. Getting in a fucking bowl of ice. Like, yo, this motherfucker is crazy. And how does it translate? You know, a lot of people ask me that too. How the fuck, like, yo, you think getting in this is gonna make you fucking successful? How the fuck do you think getting in this fucking ice is gonna make you successful in life? And look, it's because the reason is, it's because I'm putting myself out there. I'm making myself do things that I don't want to do outside my comfort zone. And that's going to help me be successful and do things that are successful. Do things that will lead to me being successful. If you're just sitting around and you're not taking any action, then you're never going to change your life. Your life will stay exactly the way it is. Think you're gonna get a new job or do something good when you just go to work every day and you don't do anything different? No, you're gonna be at the same job every day. You're gonna be doing the same thing every day unless you make a change. And the changes start like this. You have to do things like this. And ice, getting in ice water is amazing because it's probably the hardest thing that you could ever do. It's extremely difficult. Extremely difficult to get in the freezing cold water. Very, very hard to do. Now, it has all these health benefits to it and everything. You can look that up. You know, that's great. I'm not really in it for that. I'm in it for the mental challenge. And it's very hard to do when you get in that water. You know, it's fucking hard, dude. So that's what I'm doing. Sticking with it. And I won't stop. That's going to be it for this Thursday edition of the stream. Thank you all for watching. Hope everybody has a great day. And I'll catch y'all tomorrow. Later!